Hi, welcome to another episode of MYD Global. I'm your host, Leanne Hackman-Carty. When people think of disasters, they don't always think of health pandemics, times when people in the world have been infected, they've died, they've contracted various viruses. You think back on smallpox, yellow fever, H1N1, SARS virus, Ebola, even the Zika virus. But what's really scaring people today is the coronavirus and how fast it's spread from China to other places throughout the world. And it's not over yet. In today's episode, I speak with Carolyn Cross. She is the president and chair of Ondine Biomedical out of Vancouver, Canada. She's been working in the area of nasal photodisinfection for a number of years, and it's one way to stop infection and to help treat infection. So stay tuned as I speak to Carolyn about the coronavirus and how her solution may just help in stopping the spread of this pandemic. Carolyn, nice to see you today. How are you?
Very nice to be here. Nice to see you again as well, Leanne.
So Carolyn, I really wanted to talk to you today because it's so timely and what's happening in the news with the coronavirus. So before we get really into that topic, can you just explain a little bit about your background and what got you here?
My background is essentially financial, but I have for the last almost 20 years been involved with a technology called antimicrobial photodynamic therapy. And I've been involved with it because it is a new approach to killing bugs, whether they're fungus, virus, and bacteria. And I've been doing this because I'm quite concerned about antimicrobial resistance and the threats of pandemics and the potential of pandemics.
So Ondine Biomedical, tell me about how long the company's been around, what it's been doing, what its focus is.
The company has been around for well over a decade, and we have been working in British Columbia to develop first technologies for oral infections like periodontal disease and peri-implantitis. And from there, we understood the potential being far greater. And so we migrated out of the dental space focus and into hospital-acquired infections and acute and chronic infections to treat and prevent multi-drug-resistant infections that are plaguing mankind.
So what exactly, I know one of the things that you're very involved in is this nasal photodisinfection. So for someone who would not have a clue what that stands for or what it is, can you just kind of explain what it is and how it works?
Well, the first part I want to explain is that the nose is a perfect reservoir and breeding ground for all sorts of bad pathogens and germs. And the reason, because it's warm and moist, and we're not showering and cleaning out the nose very often. And as a result, it is has been identified as a leading source of self-infection. And especially when we're weakened, whether it's by surgery or by illness or by disease. And what we have done is created a very fast-acting, very effective way of eliminating all types of bugs, whether they're fungus, virus, or bacteria in the nose using light activation instead of antibiotics and the usual antimicrobials that are out there that can generate resistance.
So as far as, and cost-wise, is it more effective to do this kind of treatment?
Well, if you factor in the, it is economical. And then if you factor in the extra cost of handling patients back and forth and relying on patients to take, let's say, antibiotics when they're not complying and the resulting resistance that generating, this probably is one of the most effective ways to have peace of mind that all types of species of pathogens are in fact eliminated. This type of technology has been used and is being used in Europe to clean blood supplies and clean viruses from blood supplies. And we've translated this technology into topical decolonization applications, such as the one that we're talking about to clean the nose.
So I guess to bring it back to this coronavirus that is starting to really get some traction, not only on the media, but I mean, obviously around the world, there's showing more and more people are contracting it. I'm just curious, as far as this photodisinfection technology, is that something that could be deployed to help reduce the potential transmissions of this virus?
Knowing that light activation and photodynamic therapy can be very effective against virus and is known for being an effective antiviral technology, we believe it can be and should be a tool somewhere along the line in the arsenal that clinicians and other healthcare workers are going to be needing as we try to wrestle with this particular coronavirus from Wuhan or even others of the future. We think it's one of the tools that can be helpful.
Well, Carolyn, I know that you've been testing and proving this technology is successful in British Columbia for a number of years and are looking to expand elsewhere. I truly hope that governments and health agencies that are looking for solutions don't pass by your solution, that they seriously look at it. And I know at this point, they're probably wanting anything that will work. And so I wish you all the best in getting this out there, and hopefully we will see it very shortly in a number of areas across the country and possibly internationally.
Thank you. We are very concerned about the coronavirus coming out of Wuhan, and we would like to be of assistance where we can. We stand ready to help where we can. And I think it's going to be everybody's job to participate in controlling this. Human beings are tenacious. We learn. And when we work together, great things happen. We, of course, have phenomenal people around the world that are extremely well-trained and very capable of dealing with this crisis. They're doing an excellent job so far, but this particular coronavirus is of concern, and I think it's going to be all hands on deck. So thank you for the opportunity to tell you a little bit more about this type of technology, which hopefully can play a role.
Thank you. Thank you very much for taking the time today. I know you're a busy woman, so take care, Carolyn, and we'll be in touch soon.
Thank you, Leanne.